Hello students, today we will learn the next illustration, illustration number 7 relating to the computation of assessable value for custom duty purpose. Now see the illustration. From the following particulars, determine the assessable value of the imported equipment from Japan. Under that, FOB cost of an equipment Japan is yen 2 lakh yen. Freight charges 20,000 yen, charges for development connected to equipment paid in India rupees 60,000, insurance charges paid in India for transportation from Japan rupees 15,000, commission payable to agent in India rupees 15,000, exchange rate as per RBI is 1 yen is equal to rupees 0.45, exchange rate as per CBE&C is 1 yen equal to 0.50. So, with this information, we have to compute the assessable value. Here, in this illustration, we have to compute the assessable value. But here, in this illustration, they asked to find the assessable value by giving the FOB cost of an equipment directly. They have given the FOB cost here. Directly, they have given the FOB value. So, that is nothing but. See, once the format for computing the assessable value. Here, they have given the FOB value directly. In this illustration, they have given FOB value directly, means all these expenses have been added and this value is given directly. Now we have to compute the assessable value. Here, with the help of this illustration, we have to compute the assessable value. So the thing is, we have to add only the expenses which is incurred from port to port. So that is the freight and transportation cost, if it is by air or ship, then any insurance, if given or not given, we have to take. So only as, to find the assessable value, we have to take only, we have to add freight and transportation cost because they have given the FOB in this illustration directly. So when FOB is given in the illustration directly, so now we'll see how to solve this illustration. So remember, FOB cost is given directly. If you want, right, it is a case of FOB given directly. So when FOB is given directly, what is the solution we have to see? So FOB value 2 lakh is given. So 2 lakh yen, and we have to convert with the exchange rate. Then after that, they have given freight charges 20,000 yen. So freight charges means that is a yen, given in yen. So that is nothing but freight charges from an exporter port to importer port. What is the freight or transportation charges? Expenses relating to the import of a equipment from a Japan. So they have incurred freight charges of 20,000 yen. So this one we have to take. We have to add after FOB. So we have to add to this FOB. Then charges for development connected to equipment paid in India. So this is a development expenses. Expenses which is relating to the equipment. But it is paid in India. So the expenses or cost of development expenses which is incurred or paid in India is not taken for the assessable value computation. Then insurance charges paid in India for transportation from Japan. So the insurance charges paid in India for transportation from Japan. So that is from transportation from Japan, they have paid insurance expenses paid in India. So that is the expenses relating to exporter port to importer port. So that expenses insurance we have to pay after FOB. So that is the expenses relating to this on this transportation they have taken insurance. So for that insurance paid in India for transportation from Japan means it is the expenses incurred from port to port. So it should be added. It is an insurance they have given. Don't confuse with the word it is paid in India. So in the case of insurance, they might give freight and insurance, they might give the word paid in India like, but along with that they will give one more word, that is the transportation from Japan. So the insurance will be paid from transportation from Japan is nothing but this insurance for this transportation from a port to port. They have taken any insurance policy for the ship or a craft, aircraft. For that they have paid insurance means it is the expenses relating to the exporter port to importer port and it should be added to the FOB. Then commission payable to a agent in India. So here the importer has paid a commission in India 15,000. So commission payable to agent in India means he is a local agent. Exporter agent staying in India, for that agent importer has paid a commission. So this is nothing but local agent. Actually local agent commission we have to take while computing FOB. means here we have to take the local agent commission for computing the FOB. We have to take local agent commission, means before FOB we have to add. So in this illustration they have given FOB directly, and they again they have given the local agent commission. So at that time we have to add the local agent commission after FOB. Okay, so remember, when FOB is given directly in the illustration, then commission to a local agent or a local agent commission should be added after FOB. So this 15,000 we have to add after the FOB. Okay, so remember, when FOB is given directly, we have to take the local agent commission after FOB. Here the FOB is given directly in the illustration, so at this time, at that time we have to add the local agent commission after the FOB. Then exchange rate as per RBA is given, and exchange rate as per CBE is given. So here we have to consider the exchange rate, which is given by Central Board of Excise and Customs. So we have to consider this exchange rate, that is a 1N is equal to 0.50. So with this information we have to compute the assessable value of a imported equipment from Japan. So now we'll work out the illustration. Write the heading. So write the heading, solution number 7, computation of assessable value. So here we have to consider the exchange rate, which is given by CBEC. So that is equal to 1N equal to 0.50, 1N equal to 0.50. So now draw 3 column, particulars and 2 amount column. So here in this illustration, the importantly they have given the FOB value directly. So the solution starts with the FOB value of a goods. So this is the illustration little different. So they have given FOB value of equipment directly. They have given the FOB value directly. So FOB value, how much? 2 lakh N is given, 2 lakh. So in the N column we have to take 2 lakh. So now we have to convert this 2 lakh into Indian rupee. So that is 2 lakh into 0.50. So that is equal to rupee 1 lakh. So this is the FOB value. So after FOB we have to add these expenses. So mainly we have to add after FOB, what is the form, as per format we have to add freight or transportation cost. Freight or transportation cost. So here in this illustration they have not mentioned whether this import is by ship or air. So we have to consider, we have to assume this transportation is by ship. Assumed import is by ship. So in the case of import is by ship, what is the rule? So here FOB value is given directly, we have to start with the freight or transportation cost. So when if you are assuming this, when there is no information about relating to the import, if it is by air or ship, we have to consider, we have to assume this import is by ship. So in the case of import by ship, if they give value, then we have to take the same actual value. If they don't give any transportation or freight charges, then we have to add take 20% of FOB. So in this illustration they have given the freight charges. So they have not mentioned whether it is by air or a ship, but they have given freight charges. So we have to assume this freight is paid, this freight or transportation charges is paid for the import by ship. So now we have to take the, if given, then we have to take the value as it is, means actual value we have to take. So in the case of import by ship, so if given, if given the freight charges or transportation, then we have to take the same value actual. So what is the actual value given here, freight charges? That is equal to 20,000 yen. So in the N column write 20,000. So now we have to convert 20,000 into exchange rate 0.50. So that will be equal to 10,000. Next, after freight or transportation cost, we have to take insurance. So next, add insurance. So relating to insurance, they have given, what they have given? So here, insurance charges paid in India for transportation from Japan. So this is nothing but the insurance charges incurred for the transportation from Japan, means from a Japan port to Indian port, the expense is incurred. So that is nothing but the insurance port to port. So here this is the expenses we are adding from port to port. So here this insurance actual value is given, that is 15,000 rupee directly given. So no need to, if given we have to take, in the case of insurance if given the same actual value we have to take. So the actual value here they have given Indian rupee only, so directly we can take on the Indian rupee column, that is equal to 15,000. No need to write here because they have given the value in rupees. See here carefully, they have given the value in the rupee form, so directly take in the rupee column 15,000 as an insurance. Next, only these two are the expenses which will be taken after FOB. So now again, once check the illustration, anything is left out. So FOB value is taken, then freight charges is taken, then charges for development connected to equipment paid in India. So this is the expenses incurred in India after the import of this equipment from a Japan. This development, this importer has made a sum of the development in that equipment. For that he has incurred some of the charges. So that is incurred in India means after the import of that equipment into India, that expenses is incurred, means after paying the custom duty for the import, this expense is incurred. But this expenses which is incurred in India by the importer should not be taken for the assessable value. So we have to ignore this. Then this insurance value we have considered. Then there is a commission payable to agent in India. So the agent in India is nothing but the agent who is staying in India is nothing but the local agent, or local agent means the agent who will be staying in our country. So he is known as a local agent. So that agent is nothing but he is the exporter agent. For the exporter agent, on behalf of a exporter, importer will be paying a commission in the form of Indian rupee. So that is given in this illustration. When FOB value is given, along with that they have given the commission also. Actually this commission we used to add before FOB, but here FOB value is directly given in the illustration. So now we have to add this local agent commission at the end. Okay, after writing FOB we can take local agent commission, or you can take here immediately also, in no problem. Local agent commission we have to add after FOB. Okay, so here local agent commission they have given the value directly 15,000 they have given direct value, so write in the rupee column. Then exchange rate we have considered, there is no other information. Now we have to total this. So the total is equal to 140,000. This is nothing but the assessable value. This is nothing but assessable value. So on this assessable value we have to compute the custom duty payable. So in this illustration they have not asked about the custom duty payable, and they have not given the information about the duties also, basic custom duty or any other custom duties. They have not given the details about the custom duties calculation, charges, rate of custom duties. So we have to stop here, the assessable value. So now next you have to write the note. So see here, write the note. We have to first notice this illustration exchange rate we have considered, which is specified by CBEC. Then next second note, write charges for development connected to equipment. Second note, charges for development to equipment, development connected to equipment paid in India is an expenses paid after clearance of equipment for home consumption, hence it should not be included for assessable value. So that is nothing but the development expenses incurred in India after the import of that equipment. It is taken as a after the import of equipment for the home consumption, means for our consumption this equipment has been used, imported. So expenses incurred after the import which is paid in India is not taken for the assessable value. So we have to take, we have ignored that second, that point. So we have ignored this point because it is incurred in India. Next, one more note you have to write. Next third note, or you can write a note separately about local agent commission. So leave one line, you can continue there as a third note, or you can leave one line and start with the heading note for local agent commission. So there is a three cases. for computing the local agent commission. We have already solved these cases. So first case is when local agent commission amount given directly along with the price of machinery. So when the local agent commission, in the illustration, when the local agent commission amount is given directly along with the price of machinery, this is the one case. In that case, we have calculated, like, we have considered that local agent commission while calculating FOB, means before FOB, like as per format. So when price of goods is given and local agent commission amount also given, at that times we have added here local agent commission, means before FOB we have added the local agent commission. So same rule, when local agent commission amount is directly given along with the price of machinery, we have to consider that local agent commission while calculating FOB, or before FOB we have to add local agent commission. So if you want, I can say with the example of illustration. That is illustration number one. We have worked out the illustration number one. So here price of machinery is given and along with that local agent commission also given. So in that case, see the solution number one, when price of machinery is given and local agent commission amount also given directly, so at that time we have added the local agent commission before FOB. So that is the first case. So you have already learnt. So that is the case I am saying here, the first point, when local agent commission amount is given directly in the illustration along with the price of machinery. So at that time we have to add this local agent commission while calculating FOB, or before FOB we have to add local agent commission. Now second case for relating to local agent commission is when local agent commission is given as percentage on FOB, percentage of FOB, like local agent commission is 2% of FOB, like we have already learned this also. So in this case we have to take this local agent commission after FOB. So for this also we can take an example. See the example illustration number 4. Here cost of cigar is given, along with that they have given commission paid to local agent 2% of FOB, means it is a second case. They have given local agent commission as a percentage on FOB. They have not given the amount, like the local agent commission is rupees 10,000, like that they have not given. Instead they have given 2% of FOB. So in that case, what is the solution we have calculated is we have to take the local agent commission after FOB. So see the solution of solution number 4, we have considered this local agent commission after taking the FOB. So that is what the case says, when local agent commission is given as a percentage on FOB, we have to take the local agent commission after FOB. So that is what I have written here. In this case we have to take local agent commission after FOB. And the third case is the relating to the, our illustration number 7. When FOB is given directly in the illustration, at that time what we have to do is, in this case we should add local agent commission after FOB. So FOB is given directly in the illustration, and at that time local agent commission we have to add after FOB, means after FOB, this is FOB, here we have to add. So understood. There are three cases. In the first case, when local agent commission amount is given along with the price of machinery also given, we have to take this local agent commission before FOB. But when FOB is given, at that time we have to take the local agent commission after FOB. So that is a two case, different case. But when they have given the local agent commission as a percentage of FOB, we can see directly it is on percentage of FOB. So we have to add at the end only, after FOB only, we have to add this local agent commission. So this is about the local agent commission.